Welcome to Prudential Cleanroom Services gowning and degowning training video. The purpose of this video is to inform you on the proper procedures during gowning and degowning, along with basic personal hygiene expectations when working in a cleanroom environment. Prudential Cleanroom Services provides our customers with garments that meet or exceed the stringent levels of sterility needed in the production of medicines, microprocessors, vaccines, medical devices, and space technologies, along with many other industries. The greatest danger of contamination in a cleanroom environment is the people working in that environment. Your responsibility begins before you arrive at the processing plant. Be sure your body, hair, hands, feet, and fingernails are all washed and clean. It's also important that all jewelry, including body jewelry, be removed. This is also a time to inform your supervisor if you are sick or not feeling well in any way. Infections or viruses, no matter how mild, must be kept out of the cleanroom environment. The single largest opportunity to extend environmental controls beyond the cleanroom is by eliminating contamination in the locker room. Street clothes can allow outside contamination into the cleanroom environment. A solution to reduce this contamination is the issue of innerwear scrubs. This cleanroom professional has already gowned in her cleanroom scrubs. Cleanroom processed ESD scrubs made of a non-shedding microdenier fabric with nano-dry technology dramatically improves the performance of the cleanroom garment system, reducing actions and alerts in the cleanroom EM program. You can now safely begin the gowning process. Shoe covers and hair bouffant will be made available to you. Place a bouffant hair cover on your head, making sure to tuck all the hair under. Pull a disposable shoe cover over each shoe. Select two pairs of gloves and proper-sized garments from the storage area. This will include a hood, boots, coverall, and goggles. Enter the change room across the tacky mat, taking at least three steps with each foot to remove any debris from the soles. Put two pairs of cleanroom gloves on your hands, placing the second pair over the first pair. The outer pair will later be removed after the gowning process and prior to entering the cleanroom. Remove the hood from the packaging, making sure that the ID label is on the inside. Put the hood on, adjusting it for a comfortable yet snug fit using the adjusting snaps on the back of the hood. Remove the coverall from the package. It's extremely important to not allow the coverall to touch the ground. Hold the coverall up and unfold the coverall. Grasp right cuff to bottom right of zipper and left cuff to bottom left of zipper. Gather coverall's upper torso and step into the coverall, taking care not to let the coverall touch the floor. Place the cleanroom working gloves over or under the cuff, depending on your requirement. Snap cuffs of coverall if applicable. Snap the collar and anklets of coverall or snug up any straps. Completely zip up all zippers. Remove boots from package and put on the first boot. Snap upper leg and buckle straps as needed, then swivel that leg to the clean zone without making contact with the top of the bench. Then put on the second boot snap upper leg and buckle straps as needed. swivel that leg to the clean zone without making contact with the top of the bench. Place goggles so they cover the exposed eye area. Use a mirror to check proper gowning. Check for any exposed skin or loose straps. Then remove and discard outer pair of gloves. You are now ready to enter the clean room. The degowning procedures must be followed with the same responsibility and care as the gowning procedures. If garments are to be reworn after a break, they must be hung or stored in a controlled environment. After entering the change room, sit on the bench. Swivel both legs over to the entry zone without making contact with the top of the bench. Then unsnap and unbuckle boots one at a time without letting the boot tops touch the step or floor areas. Continue to use a bench to avoid accidental contact with the floor. Unzip coverall and remove arms from the sleeves. Grasp cuffs to waist and remove the coverall. Hang the coveralls and snap both boots to the back of your coverall legs so the boot tops do not come in contact with the floor. Remove goggles. Hang goggles on hanger or on front snap of coverall. Remove hood and snap it to the sleeve or neck opening. Garment bags may also be used for storage. As our sterile customers require, in an aseptic application, personnel are required to completely change into a new validated sterile outer garment system upon each entry, and this will require a specific sterile gowning protocol. Exit the change room and controlled areas, place the garment, boots, and goggles in the appropriate receptacle for reprocessing. Then remove and dispose of bouffant hair cover and shoe covers. These critical procedures, along with your cooperation, all play an extremely important role in maintaining Prudential Cleanroom Services' best-in-class service to our customers.